Welcome to 101 Rush. Today we bring this interesting video. Cycling revolutions. Old and creative bike designs. The bicycle as we know it evolved in the 19th century thanks to the work of several different inventors. A German baron named Karl von Drais made the first major development when he created a steerable, two-wheeled contraption in 1817. This clunky wooden prototype didn't include a chain, brakes or pedals. Instead, riders propelled the 50-pound frame forward by pushing off from the ground with their feet. Known by many names, including the velocipede, hobby horse, Draisen, and running machine, it is this early edition that has made Drais widely acknowledged as the father of the bicycle. The running machine, first model of bicycle. The first known bicycle with a verifiable record was made by a German inventor, Barn Karl von Drais. It was a two-wheeled human-powered bicycle. It didn't have paddles, crankshaft and rubber tires as we have in today's bicycles. Instead, these earlier bicycles had a wooden frame and wooden tires. They could be only propelled by pushing feet against the ground. This first bicycle was named running machine, sometimes also called hobby horse. Mr. Drais got his first patent in 1818. Then, another patent in Paris and where his bicycle got the name velocipede. Velocipede became very popular in France, but it couldn't sustain its popularity for long. Finally, after 1820, velocipedes were rarely seen. The bone shaker, a very important improvement to the running machine, velocipede, was made by Pierre Michaud. He introduced pedals in it that were attached to the axle of its front wheel. The introduction of pedals made the velocipede famous again for some time, but had not sustained its fame for long. Boneshaker declination came very fast because there was a flaw in its design. The flaw was the attachment of pedals to its front wheel, which made the steering difficult for a rider while paddling. Another reason was its heavy weight that took a lot of effort to propel it forward with pedals. This cycle got the name Boneshaker because it was very shaky on roads. High bicycle or penny farthing. The father of this model is a French, named Eugene Meyer. Mr. Eugene modified Boneshaker and made the front wheel of its bicycle large, and its rear wheel smaller for increased speed. Also, he made the frame of his bicycle very light, which further contributed to high speeds. Mr. Eugene's high bicycle was the first to be called as a bicycle. High bicycles were very good at the ride, but they presented a risk of overthrown to its rider if he braked suddenly or hit something. This risk was due to the large front wheel, which made this bicycle very unsafe. The safety bicycle. The next major phase in the development of bicycles was to improve its design and make it safer. The breakthrough came when John Kemp Starley invented safety bicycle. Safety bicycle had two equal-sized wheels and a chain drive that was attached to its crankshaft and rear wheel. Since the bicycle had equal-sized wheels, it didn't throw the rider in front of the bicycle. The safety bicycle had completely replaced the high bicycle by the year 1890. Pneumatic tires. An improvement to the tires of safety bicycle was made by John Dunlop. He invented pneumatic tires for bicycles in 1888. These tires provided much smoother ride than previously used rubber tires and were less bone shaky. New invented bicycles. The bicycle as we know it evolved in the 19th century thanks to the work of several different inventors. A German baron named Karl von Drais made the first major development when he created a steerable, two-wheeled contraption in 1817. This clunky wooden prototype didn't include a chain, brakes or pedals. Number 1. Dicycle. This unusual bike is still in the conceptual phase, but if it ever goes to production, you'll sit in between two giant wheels that can reportedly transport you directly across land and water without a hitch. Designed by the Amsterdam-based firm GBO, the boat bike hybrid would be perfect for the canals and wetlands of the Netherlands. Number 2. Bird of prey bike. This insane bike was invented by John Aldridge, who wanted to create a safe and fast bike that wouldn't put any pressure on the rider's spine. The Bird of Prey bike sees the rider lying almost face down. Despite the weird riding position, the Bird of Prey bike can achieve astonishing speeds. Number 3. Cardboard Bike. This cardboard bike prototype from Cardboard Technologies aims to reduce the cost of bike ownership, opening up the market for low-income communities. Initiated by Izar Gaffney, the company hopes to launch its cardboard bike onto the market by 2020 for around 60. The bike is primarily made from cardboard with some recycled plastic details. The cardboard itself is highly durable, as well as both fire and water resistant, supporting riders of up to 125 kilograms. Number 4. HIMO, Folding E-Bike. Xiaomi's ecological chain company HIMO has gradually gained popularity as a manufacturer of nice and solid electric bikes. The company has recently launched a new foldable electric bike dubbed HIMO H1. The model is the most portable model that has been launched so far. It can be folded to achieve a compact size that is no bigger than an A3 paper, weighing just 13 kilograms. Inside the box, there is the foldable electric scooter, an instruction manual, charger, a carrying case, and other accessories. The electric scooter comes completely assembled. All that needs to be done is to unfold, charge, and use. To understand the compact nature which allows for the scooter to assume the size of an A3 paper, the entire structure is foldable, including the handlebar, all having folding locks. Number 5. Grow Your Own Bamboo Cycle. Bamboo is an incredible material, it's fast-growing, sustainable, and strong. Using it as a bike material not only cuts the environmental costs of steel, but also creates head-turning bikes that look amazing.